Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. The Georgia Gwinnett College 2014 Fall Commencement Program will begin momentarily.
For your convenience, restrooms are located at the top of the stairwells near both of the entrances and exits to the arena. If you have difficulty locating restrooms or in need of other assistance, our GGC ushers and the arena staff will be happy to assist you. The Georgia Gwinnett College staff and student ushers are dressed in black and white attire with green and white name tags with the GGC logo. The Gwinnett Arena ushers are dressed in gray jackets. Again, these ushers are available and willing to assist you at any time during today's program activities. If at any time you or a member of your family feel you are in need of medical assistance, please notify an usher and you will be escorted to the first aid station located just inside the Gwinnett Arena main entrance.
At this time, in consideration of program attendees, please silence your cell phones and other electronic devices. We ask that your devices remain silenced for the duration of today's commencement program. For the comfort and safety of all program participants and guests, we ask you to honor our graduates and their accomplishments today by refraining from loud talking, excessive texting, blowing air horns, and using other noise-making devices during the program. This will aid us in ensuring, to the greatest degree possible, a clear broadcast of the ceremony. We also ask that you refrain from excessive movement during the ceremony to avoid distraction from the program activities.
During the ceremony, we invite you to take pictures of graduates from your seats. Please consider the visibility of other guests as you stand to take photos. Professional photographs also will be taken of each graduate during the presentation of diplomas. this.
Just let us know when.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the fall 2014 commencement ceremony for Georgia Gwinnett College. At this time, the GGC Foundation would like to thank and acknowledge our community, friends, and sponsors, as well as our faculty, staff, and students whose generosity and support have made the fall 2014 commencement ceremony possible. We would also like to express our appreciation to the Georgia Interpreting Services Network for their ongoing support of our commencement activities and acknowledge the participation of the GGC ROTC Color Guard, our soloist Stephanie Bacchisto, and our GGC staff and students for their special roles in today's commencement ceremony.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we begin the procession of the Georgia Gwinnett College faculty, graduating students, and platform party.
The processional is led by faculty representatives from four of the six schools within Georgia Gwinnett College: business, education, liberal arts, and science and technology. The two remaining schools are health sciences and transitional studies. These four faculty members are designated as standard bearers for today's commencement program.
The four faculty representatives carry a standard bearing one of the four core values of Georgia Gwinnett College: leadership, service, creativity, and scholarship.
Dr. Luis Torres, assistant professor of marketing, representing the School of Business, carries the standard of leadership. The standard of leadership reflects Georgia Gwinnett College's commitment to inspire innovation in our students and to manage change. Accordingly, GGC graduates learn to model purposeful, intentional actions that enable those around them to work together in cohesive and coherent ways toward common goals and objectives. Our students lead with both their hearts and their minds, as well as by example, and they encourage others to do the same.
Dr. Marilyn May, Associate Professor of Curriculum and Instruction, represents the School of Education and carries the standard of service. This service affirms Georgia Gwinnett College's commitment to encourage each student to contribute actively in ways that will result in a positive impact on their local, state, national, and international communities.
Dr. Adria Welcher, Assistant Professor of Sociology, representing the School of Liberal Arts, carries the standard of creativity. The hallmarks of creativity include curiosity, intellectual versatility, imagination, and critical and creative thinking. These attributes enable our graduates to embrace different modes of thought and varied perspectives, to see the relationships among disparate ideas and situations, and to forge new communications in order to arrive at innovative solutions.
Dr. Michael Somm, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, represents the School of Science and Technology and carries the standard of scholarship. This standard illustrates Georgia Gwinnett's dedication to developing graduates into lifelong intentional learners. As such, these graduates learn to discover, acquire, integrate, and apply knowledge in ways that enhance both their lives and the lives of others.
GGC faculty members process immediately behind the standards, representing the academic ranks of full, associate, or assistant professor, and instructor.
The distinct regalia worn by faculty reflect both their disciplines as well as the colors of the varied institutions where their individual degrees were conferred. Additional meaning of the colors and academic regalia is outlined on page 12 in the commencement program.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the duration of the processional, beginning with the Georgia Gwinnett College graduating class of fall 2014.
We will now begin the processional of the graduates.
Thank you.
will now begin the processional of the platform party and distinguished guests, which include the presidents of Georgia Gwinnett College, Dr. Stanley Stach-Pachevsky, senior leadership of the college, academic deans, our guest speaker, Congressman Rob Woodall, leadership of the GGC Faculty Senate, leadership of the Division of Student Affairs, the Georgia Gwinnett College Foundation, the Student Government Association, the Fall 2014 Student Speaker, and representatives from the Office of Enrollment Management.
Dr. Sam Pepas, Professor of Marketing and International Business, leads the platform party. As the senior charter faculty member in attendance, Dr. Pepas represents the entire GGC faculty.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the posting of the colors by the Georgia Gwinnett College Army Reserve Officer Training Corps and the singing of our national anthem. The national anthem will be performed by Stephanie Bacastow.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. We
have just heard the wonderful vocal talents of Stephanie Bacastow. Please continue to stand for the posting of the colors by the GGC ROTC. Want me to say that? Please remain silent for the posting of the colors. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
Now, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the president of Georgia Gwinnett College, Dr. Stanley Stash Prochevsky.
Well, good morning and congratulations, graduates, or soon to be graduates. As president of GGC, it is my distinct privilege and honor to welcome family, friends, staff, and officials to this commencement ceremony. Today, we recognize and celebrate more than 300 students who have earned their bachelor's degrees. Please hold your applause for a moment as I introduce several distinguished guests who are sharing their time with us this morning. If they would stand as I call their name, Lawrenceville Mayor Judy Jordan Johnson, State Representative Val Clark, State Representative-elect David T. Clark, and of course, United States Representative Rob Woodall, our keynote speaker, Chairman of the GGC Foundation, Mr. Tommy Hughes. Please stand. And the faculty and the staff, they look glorious today in their colors. If the faculty and staff would just stand for a moment for the appreciation of the audience and my appreciation. Thank you. Graduates, you should be quite proud of yourselves. Earning a college degree today is no small feat for anyone, and many of you have overcome significant challenges just to be here today. You've not only completed your degree requirements, you have worked and supported families. You've managed financial hurdles, dealt with family illnesses and losses, navigated job changes, and welcomed new babies into your lives. In fact, I'm told that Danae Shook might welcome a new child any minute among our graduates, so please, let's not overexcite her here today. Graduates, while you indeed did do the hard work leading to your diploma today, please do not be so naive as to believe you got here on your own. A parent, a spouse, a sibling, a friend, a professor, or a staff member, your religion or your spiritual beliefs, someone or something helped you at some point throughout your journey. So this, graduates, is your opportunity during this ceremony to stand and show your appreciation to those who have helped you through to today's achievement. This is my favorite time of year. From the Thanksgiving holiday through the New Year celebration, it is a time of pause, a time of reflection, and a time of thanks for most of us. Accordingly, if I may, as a point of personal privilege, ask you to join me in recognizing and thanking those present with us who provide for our freedoms and safety that allow us to openly gather in celebration, as well as those not present who are currently defending our freedoms overseas in harm's way. At this time, I would ask all those present who have served or are currently serving in our armed forces, our law enforcement agencies, and our fire, rescue, and EMT services, as well as their family members who stand behind them in proud support and who make their work possible through their personal sacrifices. At this time, to all of those, please stand and accept the thanks of all of us present. Please stand. Thank you for your service. For all of you graduating today, obtaining a bachelor's degree is key to your goals for a prosperous future and for yourself and for your families. Many of you, inspired by your GGC experience and bolstered by an increased belief in yourselves, have now set your sights even higher. According to our graduation surveys completed by you, 17% of you intend to go on to pursue a master's or doctorate program. including plans for medical school and law school. Others seek to advance at their current employers or to start their own business as entrepreneurs, our next generation of Bill Gates and Mark Zuckerbergs. Taylor Hardy wants to be a special agent for the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms, and Explosives. Zenobia Scott wants to start her own consulting firm. Anna Valencia plans to volunteer for hospitals in Guatemala and then go to medical school. Jonathan Reagan plans to work as an IT business analyst for Delta Airlines. Brittany Vilches, working now at Aurora Theater and plans to go to graduate school after serving in the Peace Corps. Catherine Brown says that her degree will make it possible for her to afford to make baklava all of the time for her daughters and more. And Angelo Cifuentes wants to pursue a master's degree and start his own stock exchange business. For 4 years, he has worked the night shift while going to school and finding time for his supportive wife and their two children. He graduates today with honors, and when Angelo crosses the stage to receive his degree in business administration this morning, he will become Georgia Gwinnett College's 2000th graduate. This commencement also marks yet another important milestone for the college. Today, we are graduating our very first international students, foreign citizens who specifically came to the United States to go to college. Congratulations to them. Of course, time does not permit me to list all of the distinctions this graduating class has earned as individual students or as groups. We are all very proud of the many achievements, and we look forward to hearing about your future successes. Please know that it is your success stories that inspire us in the work that we do. We reached the milestone of the 2000th graduate just before Georgia Gwinnett College begins to celebrate its 10th year of existence as we were founded in 2005. It is a perfect time to celebrate what has been accomplished in just a short 9 years and to look forward to even greater things to come. Graduates, your predecessors earned their degrees from a new and unknown college, but today you will receive your degree from a college recognized statewide, regionally, and now nationally as a leader in innovation in higher education. Your college was ranked in 2014's U.S. News and World Report as number 5 in the Southern College Group, which also recognized GGC in 2015 as the single most ethnically diverse college, public or private, in all of the South. Increasingly, we are being invited to share the GGC story at national conferences and national publications. For example, GGC was one of only 140 colleges out of 4,800 invited to attend a recent White House summit specifically focused on helping more students like you prepare and graduate from college. You should know that when we attended these events, where discussion centers on how to make higher education better across America, the ideas and the recommendations about student engagement and student success are what we've already been doing for 8 years every day in our classrooms on our campus at GGC. The leadership of other colleges, universities, foundations, and organizations across the nation are looking to us, Georgia Gwinnett College, as a model for innovation in higher education and as a driving force for change in student success, no matter the level of the student's academic preparation, no matter their learning style, their work schedule, or their financial barrier, just as GGC was envisioned to be. The dream has come true. As the vision of our founders, GGC's founding president, Dan Kaufman, that vision has now come to an unstoppable life. Two, let me recognize those elected officials and the GGC Foundation board members by asking them to stand and accept our thanks in bringing that vision to life. Trustee members and the Foundation board members, please stand. Sir, you lead it. Without them, we would not have existed. Speaking on behalf of the graduates this morning is Shahrazad Munanzi, a native of Morocco. She seeks to follow in her late father's footsteps as an American diplomat by building her own career in international relations. Her path to GGC was unusual. She took advantage of her American citizenship and came to the United States alone and at the age of only 17 to have better opportunities, meet her father's family, to learn English, the culture, and how to select and enroll in a college. After spending a year in Montana on an exchange program, Shahrazad moved to the Atlanta area to be with her father's family and then found GGC. After spending a year working in retail, she enrolled in 2010. She has served as a resident assistant, student government association senator, career ambassador, and more. Through an internship with the Crimson Academy, she helped raise funds for building a school in Rwanda. She studied abroad in Paris. She attended leadership conferences and earned membership in not less than 3 honor societies. Please welcome Shahrazad.
Thank you, President Pershevsky. My gratitude also to the Georgia Gwinnett faculty, administration, and staff. And welcome to family, friends, and special guests. Class of 2014, we finally made it. I am honored today to speak on our behalf, and I hope that my comments provide some source of inspiration for you. And like some college commencement ceremonies, where the graduates look around and they barely recognize anyone. As I am looking around, I am happy to see many familiar faces, and I hope it is the same for you as we share this new beginning. Each of us has a unique path that led us here today. My story began when I first was born in Morocco to an American father and Moroccan mother. My father worked for the US Embassy there. Where he was transferred back to the United States, my mother and I stayed in Morocco with my extended family. I always knew in my heart that I was destined to come to the United States. I imagined reuniting with my father again and following his footsteps. So I worked very hard in school so I can be better prepared for that day. However, when I was 15, my mother and I received a life-changing call. My father had passed away. After enduring this initial shock, I was filled with the resolve to face this new reality. I became even more determined to pursue my dream. No matter how difficult it would be, I knew that going to the United States alone as a teenager was a risk I had to take in order for me to seek better opportunities. Having passed the national exam and ranking among the top high in my high school, I prepared to the transition to the United States. My first stop was in Montana as an exchange student. And 8 months later, I moved to Georgia with my family, my father's family. Throughout my journey, my mother has been my inspiration. She has been my number one supporter, motivating me and encouraging me to do the best along the way. I am actually the first member of my family on my mother's side to go to college. So this is a major landmark for her and for my family, who has always been proud of my accomplishments and thankful, and I'm so thankful for all their sacrifices. Since our commencement ceremony is being streamed live, my mom and my extended family are watching us live from Morocco right now. This message is for you, my mom. كنديما كنتمنىك تكوني معايا ان شاء الله وكنتمنى بانك كتفتخري بيا. I love you, mom. In addition to my Moroccan family, I have gained a new adopted American family whose kindness, love, and support means the world for me. Especially thanks to my Moroccan American mothers, Julie Patty, Mama Pam, Mama Karen, and Miss Melinda. Sorry. I discovered GUC at a college fair, and I knew it was the right place for me. Given that English is my fourth language, I had a significant barrier to overcome. When I first attended GDC, I was enrolled in the English for academic purposes. But through determination and perseverance, I was able to advance and eventually become an honors student. Like many of you, I can relate my college experience to our four pillars: scholarship, service, leadership, and creativity, which provided me with important guidelines and helped me achieve greater success in my college experience. Perhaps my experience will help you reflect on your own. Scholarship. In addition to my courses, I studied abroad in Europe to gain a deeper insight about the European Union, bringing me closer to my goal of becoming a diplomat. Service and leadership. For me, they were both entwined as I served as a resident assistant, career ambassador, and an SGS senator while I was serving the community. Creativity. I was inspired to create a new club on campus, the Muslim Student Association, and its activities and events, bringing together the Muslim students of GEC who come from diverse backgrounds. As you can see, what we all gained from GEC is not just a degree, but a lifetime, important lifetime lessons and skills that's gonna help us achieve our dream and make a difference. I'm sure you also share gratitude to all of our professors at GEC who made invaluable contributions to our educational success. I would like to especially thank my advisors, Dr. Dovili Budrete, Dr. Douglas Johnson, and Dr. Niaz Khan, for their unrelenting support and for helping me navigate my undergraduate academic journey to a successful conclusion. Like a Rubik's Cube, life is not one-dimensional. The complexities of life can be simplified with just one right turn. One of my right turns was in New Hope Road in Lawrenceville, where I discovered that my father lies buried only a short distance from campus. This reassured me that I was truly destined to be here, and I have a purpose that I'm now equipped to fulfill. In fact, we all have a purpose. It is a matter of us pursuing it and taking the risks needed to achieve it. And when you do achieve success, remember these words by Nelson Mandela: education is the most powerful weapon you can use to change the world. Class of 2014, you have the power to change the world. Congratulations, good luck, and go Grizzlies.
She's a perfect example of the GGC vision coming to life as our college transforms higher education and transforms individuals. It's now my distinct honor to introduce your speaker for the fall 2014 commencement class, Georgia's 7th District Congressman, United States Representative Rob Woodall. Rob Woodall has been a friend to GGC since he was first elected to Congress in 2010. In fact, before he was even elected, he came out for a debate on our campus, and our students had the privilege of hearing from the future congressman firsthand. It was an exciting evening, and Congressman Woodall has continued to visit the college and meet with our students several times throughout the year. Although he's been in Congress for only 4 years, he has made a name for himself on Capitol Hill. He's a longtime proponent of the fair tax legislation, a measure that would replace all current taxes with a national sales tax. He's a member of the House Committee on Oversight and Government Reform, the powerful House Committee on Rules, where he is chairman of the Subcommittee on Legislative and Budget Process and the House Budget Committee. In the upcoming 114th Congress, you will also sit on the all-important Transportation and Infrastructure Committee. I cannot think of a single instance when the Congressman was invited to join and visit with us at GGC that he has turned us down. Just last year, he came out to campus and devoted an entire morning to have breakfast with our honors students, talk politics, and answer questions about serving in the United States House of Representatives. He also took time out on election night of 2012 to come to our election night party on campus, talk with our students, and watch his own election night returns. It's not often that an elected official will devote that kind of quality time to just one institution. Like all of the GGC faculty and staff, he is committed to our students collectively and individually. Of course, we may have some competition. I understand he was lecturing to second graders this morning prior to being with us, but those are our future GGC students. We are particularly grateful to have Congressman Woodall with us today to inspire and encourage our graduates as they complete this chapter of their lives and head out to begin a new chapter. Please give a traditional grisly welcome to our dear friend and Georgia Gwinnett College supporter, United States Representative Rob Woodall.
I wasn't nervous, Stosh, until it was the grisly welcome that I was going to get, and I started to get a little rattled. I've never spoken to a college graduation before. I've done high school graduations, and high school is different because, for those of you who remember it as I do, I was as smart as I ever was on that day at 18. Right, I knew it all. It was all going to be a gravy from there. You all have a little different perspective on the world. If I could just ask, because I think we're in the circle of trust here. Together. Who's the youngest person graduating today? Anybody 21 and graduating today? Anybody 20 and graduating today? Oh, man, Whitney. Can I go the other direction? Is that okay in the circle of trust? Anybody in their 40s and graduating today? All right. We're not done with the circle of trust yet. Anybody in their 50s and graduating today? All right. No. I'm going to have to ask. Anybody going to confess to being in their 60s and graduating today? Sold to the gentleman in the 50s, right back here. Your president talks about my commitment to GGC. I got to tell you, I'm in politics, so it's not that complicated. You guys are rock stars, right? Just rock stars. It's been 100 years since we tried to start up a four-year university, and you didn't just come. We didn't build it and folks came. We built the building, and you built the tradition. Again, in that circle of trust, who only showed up here for a semester or two, a year or two, and you were going to transfer out somewhere else pretty quickly? Confess to me. This is a part-time episode for who? Uh-huh. But it gets its hooks in you. You see the opportunity here, and everybody in the community is not only invested in your success, but proud of that success. How many of you are going to stay here in the community when you're done now? I'm going to ask the other question. Who's going to tell me, look me in the eye? Because they say that in politics. The only people I believe are the ones who look me in the eye and say, Rob, I'm going to vote against you. Right? That's a vote you can count on. That's absolutely going to happen. Who's going to look us in the eye and tell us they're going to take their big brain and they're going to leave the great state of Georgia and go practice their craft elsewhere? Who's committed to leaving us? Miss, leaving us? We've still got some time to work on you folks. I want to do some of that. I want to talk about the American dream. The American dream. Stosh talks about GGC being the most diverse institution in the in entire southern United States. I don't think that speaks at all to a diversity of the American dream. Now, when I was coming along, the American dream was owning your own home. I will ask the folks who are supporting you in the crowd here today. I'm told now the American dream is getting your adult children out of your home. Is there any truth to that? I've heard that's where we are. But I see nothing but opportunity. I, Is somebody going to confess to being a little frightened about their future as they sit here today? Anybody going to confess to having some reservations about where we're headed? That was a sympathy confession, sir, and I appreciate that. I have nothing but optimism about the future, but it doesn't happen. It's not a Washington, D.C. optimism. It's a Lawrenceville, it's a Gwinnett County, it's a community optimism, because the best that we have to celebrate as an American tradition comes from here. I talked to so many folks about what they want to do with their lives. In second grade class I spoke to this morning, there were at least 9 people who thought the President of the United States was where their career path was going to end one day, and I hope that they're right. We need good people to pursue that path. Couple wanted to have a career playing video games and believe that was gonna work out. Is anybody, as you sit here today, absolutely certain that for your American dream, you're gonna be fabulously, fabulously wealthy? I mean, Bill Gates style fabulous wealth, Mark Zuckerberg fabulous wealth. Gonna have some folks up. I want to get with Mr. Hughes and the foundation and come and visit with you all before you get out of here today. Those of you who are gonna have fabulous wealth. I wish that upon you. I wish that upon you if you're after it. I happen to look at people on either sides of the aisle here who have committed themselves to never having fabulous wealth. And I'm grateful. I'm grateful to them for doing that. Can I ask you that? Is it you're picking up your parchment this afternoon? Any of you absolutely certain you're gonna have a life that's full of poverty but rich with happiness? Do you know that financial remuneration isn't gonna be in the cards for you? You're choosing a different path. When they putting together our founding documents, you've heard the story. It's life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, but it was life, liberty, and the pursuit of property. That was the tale. And folks knew that we weren't going to find happiness with stuff, that the American dream wasn't going to be about stuff. If that happens to be a way that you can provide, that you can contribute, that you can grow the economy, more power to you. But as a people, that's not where we began, and it's not where we are today. On a per employee basis, the patents that grow this country, the innovation that grows this country, 16-fold more patents go to individuals than go to larger corporations, right? The innovation, the productivity gains come from the ground up. 2/3 of the jobs created in this country come from the ground up. Who is committed as you sit here today not to go to work for the man, but to hang out your own shingle and do your own thing and live life on your terms? Who's committed to that? Committed to that. That is where the innovation happens in America. I more power to you if you want to go to Coca-Cola. My dad worked for the power company his entire life. We've got lots of great corporate citizens here. But the magic that happens, the magic in the American dream that happens, is that magic that comes from folks who take on the risks that other folks aren't willing to take. I've got to believe investing your time and your energy in what was once an unproven university. What was an unproven university, and you came and proved it. What was once an experiment that we were conducting here, you came and made it a reality. I worry that we're training risk-taking out of America. I worry that failure is somehow a bad word. I think I've learned more from my failures than I have from my successes, and I suspect you have been the same way. It's the dream that separates us from so many other folks. Can I ask who comes from a family where you or your parents are first generation in this country? Folks who didn't have the privilege of knowing nothing but the American dream. I have two kinds of people in my office talking about how to make your life better. Just so you know, Washington, D.C., full of really smart people who care a lot about you. If you're just willing to live your life the way we tell you to, there is happiness in the offering. Just want you to know that now. Happiness in the offering. But occasionally, folks like to live life on their own terms. I have two kinds of people in my office. I have folks in my office who come and complain about the way everybody else is living their life. And I have folks in my office who came here from somewhere that freedom did not live, where opportunity did not live, where a chance to make your tomorrow better than your today was not available. And those folks love freedom, and the American dream in ways that I can never understand. If you, thinking about those folks who stood up that we applauded for your service in the military, if you've not put on the uniform to defend freedom, or if you haven't escaped somewhere where you didn't have freedom, freedom becomes just a word. If opportunity is what you've, if it's what you've known, opportunity becomes just a word. Dreaming becomes those things that you do to pass the time, not those things you do to set a goal. How many of you never believed you'd find the day that you were sitting to receive your graduation certificate today? Never believed it. Now, sir, you didn't believe it because you weren't committed to it, were you? You doubted some of your commitment along the way. Who didn't believe it because they didn't think that that was in the cards for them? They weren't entitled to that. They weren't going to be able to make that happen. Sir, I'm going to tear up just looking at you down there. I am. How many of you could have done it alone? How many of you were strong enough, smart enough to do it alone? When I think about the American dream, I'm not thinking about Mark Zuckerberg. I'm not even thinking about Rob's Automotive Repair, though I would tell you that I can fix your car better than most folks can. I'm thinking about the way that we rely on each other and how we're stronger together than we are individually. Who's the first in their family to pick up one of these diplomas this afternoon? Anybody the first? Wow. They are probably also deserving of a round of applause. Anyone the last in their family to pick up one of these? The bills are done being paid. Everybody, okay, good. This thing we have called America, you know, I carry the rule book in my pocket. I've got the Constitution. It's not something that governs itself. It's something that we have to renew each and every day. There is so much pessimism that I bump into every day. There's so much cynicism that I bump into every day. There's so much, the odds are stacked against me, Rob, and I can never make it happen that I run into every day. And then Stosh calls me and says, will you come speak to people who make it happen for themselves every day because they're surrounded with a support network that won't allow them to fail. Folks are counting on you. I'm closer to death than I am to birth. I'm going to get out of here okay. I don't want you to worry about me. But I'm counting on your success. Pay those Social Security checks coming along the way. There may be some other folks here in the crowd who are counting on you along the way. Your success is not guaranteed. But your commitment guarantees our success as a people. I look at the folks who have decided to invest their lives in making you and me better. Folks who have decided to invest their lives so that we can have the freedom to invest our lives however it is that we choose. Folks who have made their life's work, enabling us to do things that we never could have done otherwise. I call that service. I call that the highest and greatest calling. And when it's in colorful robes, it looks even prouder and more distinguished than I have imagined. We don't do any of this. Alone. I wish upon you the American dream that you choose for yourself. I will quote the great poet Eminem. If you had just one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you want in just one moment, would you grab it or would you let it slip? You never know when opportunity is going to come knocking on your door. You never know when you're going to have the chance to fulfill your dreams. You never know when you're going to have a friend who is down and who is out, and you can make the difference in their lives. These folks who sit to your left and your right will never know if they were the one who touched you and changed your life forever. But we have that opportunity each and every day. Leadership, scholarship, service, and creativity. I wish each and every one of those upon you in abundance. And if I find myself on the stage looking for a great poet 20 years from now, I hope that I'm quoting some of your successes that have happened along the way. Congratulations for what you have accomplished. And my greatest wish that you accomplish everything that you dream in the future. Thank you for letting me be here with you today. I appreciate that.
coming.
I know, right? Good morning. My name is Chase Goodwin, and I am the current George Gwinnett College Student Government Association president. As I was sitting here, I was trying to think of a word that exemplifies the experiences that I've had with Congressman Roydahl, going back to that election bash in 2012. And as I was there, I thought of the word sincere. And it comes from a Latin word, a Latin phrase meaning without wax. And back in ancient Rome, they would put that on their sculptures and their pottery to show that it was real. And they would fill the cracks with wax to a cheap sculptor would fill their cracks with wax. And this became a problem because over time the wax would crack and crumble. So the word we use as an honest expression of an honest feeling means something that will stand the test of time. And on behalf of the students of George Gwinnett College, I would like to sincerely thank you, Congressman Woodall, for being here today to bestow upon us your wisdom and thoughts that will stand the test of time. And a special thanks for the exemplary support of George Gwinnett College. In appreciation of the positive impact your words will have on us for the years to come, it is my honor to present you with this gift on behalf of the students of George Gwinnett College and the graduating class of 2014. Thank you.
Okay, rowdy crowd, settle down. Hockey's tonight, not right now. We will proceed now with the conferral of degrees. I call on the interim Senior Vice President for Academic and Student Affairs and our Provost, Dr. Lois Richardson, to acknowledge those candidates who will graduate with honors and to introduce the deans who will present the graduates for the diplomas.
Thank you, President Prochesky. In a moment, the deans of the School of Business, the School of Education, the School of Liberal Arts, and the School of Science and Technology will present the candidates for the baccalaureate degrees, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Science in Education, Bachelor of Arts, and Bachelor of Science. First, we will recognize those candidates who will graduate with special honors. Students graduating with these honors will be noted as they receive their degrees. Those graduating summa cum laude have earned a grade point average above 3.875. Magna cum laude reflects those graduates who earned a grade point average above 3.75. And those students graduating cum laude have earned above a 3.50. Will those students graduating with special honors please rise and be recognized? Thank you. Please be seated. At this time, in order, the following deans will present the candidates for their applicable degrees. Dr. Tyler Yu, Associate Dean of the School of Business, Dr. Kathy Moore, Dean of the School of Education, Dr. Adolfo Santos, Dean of the School of Liberal Arts, and Dr. Thomas Mundy, Dean of the School of Science and Technology.
President Prochesky. On behalf of the faculty of the School of Business, it is my privilege to present the candidates who have completed the prescribed course of study for the baccalaureate degree in business administration. These candidates have, by character and achievement, as judged by the faculty, proved worthy. Will the candidates for the degree Bachelor of Business Administration and the faculty of the School of Business please rise? Please be seated.
President Prochaska, on behalf of the faculty of the School of Education, it is my privilege to present the candidates who have completed the prescribed course of study for the Bachelor of Science in Education. These candidates have, by character and achievement as judged by the faculty, proved worthy. Will the degree candidates with the majors of Early Childhood Education and Special Education and the faculty of the School of Education please rise? Please be seated.
President Prochaska, on behalf of the faculty of the School of Liberal Arts, it is my privilege to present the candidates who have completed the prescribed course of study for the baccalaureate degree of science and the baccalaureate degree of arts. These candidates have, by character and achievement as judged by the faculty, proved worthy. Were the degree candidates with majors in English, history, political science, criminal justice, and psychology, and the faculty of the School of Liberal Arts, please rise. Please be seated.
President Prochaska, on behalf of the faculty of the School of Science and Technology, it's my privilege to present the candidates who have completed the prescribed course of study for the baccalaureate degree of science. These candidates have, by character and achievement, as judged by the faculty, proved worthy. Will the degree candidates with majors in biology, information technology, exercise science, and mathematics, and the faculty of the School of Science and Technology, please rise? Please be seated.
And here it comes. Will all of the 2014 candidates for graduation, the faculty and the deans, please rise? By the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the University System of Georgia, I now confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Science in Education, Bachelor of Arts, or Bachelor of Science, for which you have been recommended by your dean and the faculty, with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. Congratulations. Please move your tassel to the left side of your hat to signify your new status. Please be seated. Graduates, as Congressman Woodall issues the diplomas, you'll be congratulated by him and the dean of your school. Now those who are to receive their diplomas, please come forward as your name is called.
Oh, no!
They'll be coming from that side.
Go. Ayaba Adwayam. Emmanuel Akinleya. Pollyanna Arujo. Jillian M. Attridge. Mary Delin Murray Bailey. Elizabeth Margot Baker. Stephanie Denise Baldwin. Joanna M. Barrow. Brandon W. Best, magna cum laude. Michael Benkowski. Raven Nicole Blackwell. James Bolden Jr. Neil Donovan Bonaparte. Dion LaCorey Bowman. Alejandra Buendia. Amanda Nicole Butler. Keegan Gail Nicholas Carey, cum laude. Corey Alexander Carnell. Carlos Castillo. Angelo F. Cifuentes, cum laude, and Georgia Gwinnett College's 2000th graduate.
So as soon as you get in the car, stop the steps. Call your name. Good. That's what I need everybody to do.
Zachary Hunter Cole. Deborah Koroyan, cum laude. Merdad Day. Anthony Heen Dang. Lex M. Davis, cum laude. Kristen LaCole Edwards. Nakisha S. Facey. Jose Carlos Figueroa. Michael Heath Garman, cum laude. Sharon Smith Gibson. Christopher Wayne Gilly. Kristen Lee Genta. Brent Robert Gonzalez. Yomara Jareth Gonzalez. Frederick Eli Green. Sharon Ann Hampton. Taylor James Jackson Hardy, cum laude. Blake Renee Harmon. Ariel Jordan Harris. Megan Elizabeth Hartman. Jabril Hersey, minor in information technology. Lindsay Paige Holbrook. Neva Larson Hurditch. Nerman Jakopovich. Tony John, cum laude. Matthew Kaufman. Chelsea Elizabeth Knowles. Mitchell Allen Cokite. Sarah Elizabeth Latham. Elsie Lisbeth Lopez Feria. Weston Chase Love. Samadia Alexa Lyles. Sana Makani. John Cal Massengale. Mark Allen Millard. Daniel Caleb Miller. Andres Molano. Lorena A. Morchio, cum laude. Leslie Elizabeth Morgan. William A. Mulliken. Shema Shaka Munyaziza. Francelia Nelthrop, cum laude. Natasha L. Nickelberry. Robert C. Payne. Jorge A. Peralta Rosales. Ignacio Rosani, cum laude. John Henry Carl Quirrell, cum laude. John W. Rabon. Jonathan Neil Reagan. Joseph Leo Ramey the Fourth. Arisha M. Relaford, cum laude. Tarina Sophie. Zenobia Jacqueline Cecilia Scott. Russell Shanker. Danae Shook. Christine C. Sinkula. Joshua Kingsley Smart. Morgan Wheeler Smith. Robert Sloan Strickland. Linda Suazo. Kara McKibben Swansea, summa cum laude. Madison Ann Titshaw. Joshua Uloa. Laura Uzamakunda. Christian Thomas Van Camp. Casey Glenn Versiglio. Erica A. Villanueva. Cindy Fong Bo. Karina Otaneda Waldrop, magna cum laude. Michael Daquan Walker. Carly Noel Wilson. Morgan B. Wilson. Jennifer L. Wormley. Nicole Lynn Zagorski, cum laude. Angela Lynn Zuardo. Amber Ray Allen, summa cum laude. Kristen Michelle Black, summa cum laude. Brooke Gabrielle Blackburn. Mary Catherine Brown. Samantha Louise Bryan. Crystal Ann Cannon. Damaris Y. Collins. Mary Catherine Curtis, cum laude. Sherman England Davis III. Samantha Raquel Downey, cum laude. Eric Evans Jr. Jessica Ford. Jamie Garcia Ramirez, cum laude. Daniela Michelle Godby. Jasmine C. Smith. Susan Ann Haggerty, cum laude. Jennifer Elizabeth Ionescu, cum laude. Anna Grace Johnston, summa cum laude. Laura Liliana Lancheros, cum laude. Juan An Dang Lee. Ashley Lauren Liddell. Novella Lee Mook, cum laude. Christy Michelle McNeil, summa cum laude. Courtney Nicole Meldacious, cum laude. Jennifer Denise Nunez. Chelsea Miranda Oliver. Carlos Oyanandel. Defki Patel. Anisha Deneen Riley. Kimberly D. Robinson. Morgan Brittany Roldan. Amanda Christie Stroud. Andrea Nicole Taylor. Lydia Azaneth Webb. Laura Ann Berry, cum laude. Ashley Brownlow. Danielle Denise Fraze. Belvis Hayrich, cum laude. David John Lake. Jennifer Elizabeth Maddox. Haley Caitlin Nash. Peggy M. Newton, cum laude. Christopher Paul Bishop. Cristobal Andreas Burns. Ellen Goodwin Campbell, summa cum laude. John Hall, cum laude. Jessica Hannon, minor in history. John Patrick Hendry, cum laude. Jennifer Lynn Lamoy. Mary Catherine Morris, summa cum laude. Morgan Virginia Nally. Kyle Jordan Alexander Reed, minor in information technology. Tammy Suerte Felipe, cum laude. Reed Templeton, summa cum laude. Lauren Nicole Thompson, magna cum laude. Brittany Noel Vilches. Julie Ann White, magna cum laude. John Bryce Gordon. Shannon Nicole Peterman, summa cum laude. Braden Edwin Tabor, cum laude. Archivius Crane. Whitney Nicole Duran. Vasily Kiriev. Scheherazad Munaji. Andrea Yu Tan Nguyen, cum laude. Sean Brandon O'Donovan. Carrie Rose Pritchard. Rodney Eugene Virgil. Lucas Gregory Byer. Ryan Austin Breedlove. Kristen Jacqueline Collins. Nathan B. Daly. Yeah! Shamika Denise Ernest. Andrew Reese Elder. Kevin Michael Geiger. Joshua Matthew Grimsley, cum laude. Robert James Piper. James Peter Spate. Allison Michelle Stalvey. Rachel Ashley Stubbs. Lindsay Aaron Thomas. Lee Malcolm Tyler. Renee Melissa White. Taylor Marie Allen. Brenda Allen Williams. Holly Danae Barker. Carrie Anne Marie Bullard. Robertson Paul Demersman. Shazada Dono. Rebecca Christine Fannin. Mercita Flippin. Natalie Ryan Holman. Stephanie Monique Holmes, cum laude. Jaleesa Sade Ide. Kelly Lee Kennedy. Teron R. Lindsay, cum laude. Christy Joy Lott. Lois Evelyn Lupe. Juan Martin Matute Fellheimer. Kelly Catherine Maynard. Vicky Marie Prate. Harrison M. Priestley. Brittany N. Ricky. Rachel G. Sabatino, magna cum laude. Robert Scott Schneider. Rachel Elise Skinner. Maria Alejandra Valencia de Leon. Angelica Renee Willis. Garland Annette Williams. Melanie Christine Williams, cum laude. Travis Lee Wright, Jr. Sabrina Alam. Samantha Alexandria Maria Botello. Angela K. Burrow, summa cum laude. Amelia Jeanette Davidson, cum laude. Jasmine Chantal Edmondson. Sarah Victorian Fuller, cum laude. Amber Michelle Gunter. Benjamin Hasanovich. Magna cum laude. Ibrahim Imtiaz. Mindy Brianna Lee. Justin Mark Madden. Emily T. McCloy, magna cum laude. Gerald Christopher Miller. Samantha No. Osa Edwin Obasuyi. Chong Sok Oh. Dana Michelle Orban. Brandon R. Orta, magna cum laude. Jessica Lynn Park, summa cum laude. Stephanie Perdomo. Timothy Persaud. Victoria Lee Purcell. Jeremy Oliver Sasso. Matthew Daniel Stanancia. Summa cum laude. David Myung Su. Hutan Vakili Dastard. Anna Consuelo Valencia. Gao Chia Vang. Jessica Amy Wilkerson. Jonathan Choi Yi, minor in information technology. Jennifer Booyan. Renee Jikong Inang. Nathan Gravely, cum laude. Casey Green, summa cum laude. Brene Ayana Herbert. Heaven Lee Hinton. Tan Heen Ishmael, cum laude. Joshua Michael Morgan. Mark L. Willems. Sabrina Azad. Eric Boizo. William Michael Coffey, magna cum laude. William Thomas Needham Duncan. Dolores T. Griffin. Logan M. Hasbrook. Lee Antonio Hernandez. Jason Charles James, cum laude. Bradley Eric Kudica. Raymond Levesque, cum laude. Danny Mansour, cum laude. Regina D. McCulloch. Ruben A. Mendez. Lewis Patterson, Jr. Jesse Perkins. Rajesh Ramzarup. Marcus Rogers. Everett Q. Rucker. Peter Sam. Jordan R. Smith. Christopher Lee Solomon. Stephen Thomas Spahn. Kristen Jane Audrey. Megan Lee Chambers. Nicholas Strother, summa cum laude.
Join us in congratulating the graduating class of 2014.
One more time for the class of 2014.
Please be seated, and thank you.
Good morning, graduates. On behalf of the Alumni Association, I would like to congratulate and welcome you all as our newest members. My name is Chad Miller, and I'm the chair of the Alumni Association Board. And real quick, can we get all the alumni to stand for us, please, that are here? The alumni. If y'all not eating, thank you. Y'all obviously haven't eaten your Wheaties this morning, because all y'all are alumni, too. Stand up. All right, y'all can sit down now. I hope y'all all stay involved with the school and the Alumni Association. Keep an eye out for letters and emails regarding events and networking opportunities that the association will put on, like our homecoming and our annual holiday event. And finally, I encourage you to donate to the foundation in case, if you haven't already. It's through those gifts and contributions that the Alumni Association is able to do all that we do. So once more, congratulations, and I hope to see you all soon at the next alumni event. Go Grizzlies!
Stephanie Baskestow will now sing the Georgia Gwinnett College alma mater. Please stand.
We have gained wisdom and honor from our home of green and gray. We will go forth and remember all we've learned along the way. And with knowledge and compassion, we will build communities, leading by example and with dignity. Georgia Gwinnett, we'll ne'er forget how we have grown and those that we've met. Georgia Gwinnett, with love and respect, our alma mater, Georgia Gwinnett. Our alma mater, Georgia Gwinnett.
Thank you, Stephanie Baskestow, for that wonderful rendition of the alma mater. You may be seated.
Guests and friends, the faculty and graduates will soon begin their recessional by following the tradition established at GGC. In keeping with this tradition, the platform party will depart first, followed by the faculty. The faculty will exit their seats and form two lines opposite one another. The graduates recess through these lines as the faculty congratulate and communicate with their former students. This gauntlet represents the close relationships and strong bonds built among the faculty and the graduates during their time shared at GGC.
Now please remain in place for the exit of the platform party, the recession of the faculty, and the fall 2014 graduates in that order. Ladies and gentlemen, this will now conclude our ceremony. Thank you for coming.
Please, everybody, please remain in place for the recessional of the platform party. Also, please remain for the recession of the faculty and the graduates in that order. Thank you.
Thank you.